IMT Ghaziabad has a very strong legacy. It started almost 40 years back in 1980, and it was established by an entrepreneur. At that time, only IIMs and certain leading schools were there. In fact, only four IIMs were there, not many were there by 1980 when it was established. So basically, the idea was to provide a kind of a platform where people will execute skills in entrepreneurship, innovations, and of course, social responsibility. These are the key words on which, because he himself was an entrepreneur, the founder, so he thought that let students also have this kind of philosophy, because after all, the economy is going to look up by both public as well as the private sector. So therefore, a good quality education in private sector also is important. And that's the reason why IMT was established in way back in 1980. So we have a legacy of 40 years. We have PGDM full-time, we have PGDM marketing, we have PGDM finance, we have PGDM dual country program, DCP, which is actually 1 year in IMT Ghaziabad, 1 year in IMT Dubai. And then we have a PGDM executive and then PGDM part-time. These are six PGDM programs. And IMT also has FPM. We have introduced fellow program in management, that is the equivalent of PhD. So these are our programs, and it has been going on very smoothly, and we have different kind, and IMT does not believe in carrying same kind of curriculum. We have very systematic periodic evaluation of the curriculum, and we bring in changes and we incorporate changes. Except part-time, all of them are accredited by AACSB, the top accredited body in the world. AACSB is Association to Advanced Collegiate School of Business. Now that is only 14 institutes so far in this, out of so many thousands of B-schools in India have got this accreditation. And IMT had the distinction to get it at the fourth. It was the fourth institute to get this accreditation in 2016. In fact, we are going for its renewal in 2021, the second spell of the renewal. Minimum at least 93 percentile, CAT percentile, minimum. That is the cutoff point. Normally we get around sometime 96, 97, 98 percentile students. So quality of the students is really quite good. We look at the experience, we look at his career also, how he has done. We look at his 10th, 12th graduation, all the marks, you know, how he has done. So it's a very rigorous process. Then we have written examination also. Now we look at, you know, written analysis, all kind of, you know, he's somebody who is all-rounder. Now we have to look at, because ultimately business management education is not like university education in the sense. Management education focuses on application part. And for application, you have to be street smart. And for being street smart, you have to have a lot of skills. Knowledge followed by skills, and your attitude also has to be really, really good. We have also made efforts. Now we have about 68 or 70% engineering students. Rest of them are from commerce, science, and other background, arts and all of that. Liberal arts and all that we are trying to infuse. I mean, we are in the process to get it done very quickly. And gender diversity, yes, of course. We have roughly, you know, we have a very large batch, you know, almost around 600. So gender diversity, we are trying, but we have something around, say, 27-30%, not we have reached around 27%. I think we have to, only the other day we had a meeting, how to have more women candidates in our campus. Other than that, we have to take a conscious decision, and we have to probably award some kind of, we don't know how we will go about it, because so far our focus has been only on the merit. Only on the merit. So whosoever comes in the merit, so that is, and of course, because there are a lot of seats, so we get a lot of, about some 22, 23 states are represented in IMT, so it's a kind of mini national, it's a kind of a good diversity there on that point of view. Luckily in faculty, we have a lot of women, you know, they are more than the male faculty members. They're more than 50% women are as faculty members. We have not done any kind of a compromise on the quality of the students, no compromise on the cutoff percentile so far. And next year we'll see if because where we have, we are feeling that women can get a bit less, it should be more. So for that, we have to take a decision what you should do. Should we award some extra marks like some of the IIMs did, IIM Kozhikode and IIM Calcutta and others did? I really don't know. We'll have to take an in-house decision for that. IIMT has been known for marketing. I mean, it is a top brand for marketing. And so most of the students get placed in marketing. And also we have started something called Banking and Financial Services, PGDM BFS we have introduced. So among other, another program which I forgot to include at that point of time, that we have started something called BFS, Banking and Financial Service, PGDM BFS. And that too with in collaboration with Vlerick School of Business from Belgium. And Vlerick School of Business is a Triple Crown Institute. It is accredited by AACSB, AMBA and EQUIS. So we have deliberately gone for that because we want to make a distinction between PGDM Finance and PGDM BFS. And that people should understand because these core skills are different, little bit of different. So those things we are trying. So, and we hope that we should be able to do that. Placement has been going extremely well because last year we have average salary about touching about 14 lakh and median salary about 12 lakh. Highest is being 58 lakh and in the international placement, domestic placement highest is about 34 lakh. Because as you said, COVID is a COVID. So roughly around maybe about 8 to 10% students were left out, but we are still trying to help them and give them the opportunity to get into. We have Amazon, Deloitte, Goldman Sachs, Reliance Industries, Cognizant, Mahindra & Mahindra, EY, Flipkart, ITC, McKinsey, Nestle, HUL, PepsiCo, Infosys, Cisco, L&T, Google, Airtel, Accenture, ICICI Bank, Wipro, HSBC, RBS, and just a few, named a few. There are plenty. Fully residential. All students stay in the campus, all students, without any exception. And even if a local person from Ghaziabad or any part of Delhi NCR is required to stay in the hostel, because what happens in the management, as you are aware, a lot of group exercises are there. If somebody is coming as a day scholar, he will miss out a lot of things. And most importantly, as you know, campus life is very vibrant. You know? The activities go till 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock early morning. You know, this is the kind of culture, this is the kind of students you get, you know, who are more busy in the night rather than the daytime. And also what we do, we facilitate students in terms of a lot of clubs and groups, you know, activity clubs. So they so display these leadership qualities as well as doing a lot of things on their own. Hardly faculty interferes, and then they do fantastic jobs. And I must say that, you know, I have been in several institutes prior to joining IIMT Ghaziabad, but this is something really, really good. It is, you know, summer internship is of course mandatory for everybody, and we have no problem at all. Every year they get very good summer internship project. The stipend goes as high as 1,20,000 and all that. So they are, that's really good. But in addition to that, we have something very unique course, which is mandatory for all the passing out graduates from IIMT. That is called Sustainability and Social Responsibility. That's a unique course that is in line with the UN principles of responsible management education. So we are one of the few institutes in the country who are known for this responsible management education, and this course is recognized by UN. And we what is this? Project-based course. People do something which is socially valued as good, something which students can contribute. They themselves form small groups, faculty only act as a mentor. They come out with certain kind of project proposal and they implement and execute it. So they have that, they give a something, you know, their imagination, some kind of true color, you know, they can do something which is close to their heart, which otherwise they would not have been able to do that. And in addition to that, we have introduced electives like corporate social responsibility. So that fits in well. And this is critical because sustainability is going to be the key in the future. Without sustainability, I think we're not going to survive. So that's very important. So IIMT has taken special care about that. We also permit students to do the live projects. How? industry link. And I would say, for example, this time Mahindra and Mahindra asked us, our students, to do live projects. Some about 6-7 projects we did, and you know, again, that focused on green marketing, green building, green, you know, sustainable finance, water conservation strategies, products, and all that. So students were exposed to this kind of issue. So we are encouraging more and more such live projects. Brand value. IMT has always been consistently ranked among the top business schools of this country, irrespective of IIMs and IITs. And in, among the private, you are always in the top 5. And overall, you are always within the 15, including IIMs and IITs. So it is a top brand values there, legacies there. Illustrious alumni are there who have done extremely well and made us proud. So people look up to, you know, like somebody can ask why football is popular in Bengal or Kerala, because they have traditionally done well in that field. Similarly, in management, our students have done extremely well. Our alumni have done in the industry. So obviously, it becomes a referral point for the incoming students. So that is how we have succeeded. Students who are looking for good job in marketing, they should look at IMT. We have highest, you won't believe, in marketing, we have so many, about 60 electives and all that. So many kind of electives and so many kind of courses, because marketing is sought after. There are some courses where we have 390 students opting for a particular course. So that's something very high. So marketing followed by finance, then of course HR operations and all that. So people see value for money while coming to IMT. They think that, you know, it fits into their aspirations, because students are aspirational. They also look at, I know every parent or the student decide which institute gives the best good placement to their career options to the students. So that all said and done, many times student may not look at your ranking, may not look at your accreditation, but they look at the placement profile. And that is where we score and students opt for IMT. You can, you know, if somebody scores a good percentile, he gets into a good college, obviously. But it does not mean that one should lose hope. Now, you take an example from Satya Nadella and others. They necessarily did not belong to IIT, but they did well. So what is important is that you self-belief. I think if you can believe in yourself and you have confidence, I think anywhere one can do well. I think in the top 100 or top 200 B schools, if not IIMs or not top 15 or 20 private B schools, but there are other B schools equally good, they should not lose hope that if I cannot get into IMT or IIM or something, they should believe in themselves and that they should opt for other colleges or wait for another year to do well and get into some good colleges. Because ultimately, for parents, you know, like I am a parent, you know, I can say that students will always say, now which college will provide me the best opportunity? Believe it or not, students do more research than the parents do.